My name's Tim Brennan, and I'm the dad of TJ Brennan.
I'm 15 years old, and I'm here to talk about type 1 diabetes and celiac disease. There's a hero, if you look inside your heart, you don't have to be afraid of what you are. I found out I had diabetes when I was 9 years old, right before soccer season started. I had been pretty sick for about 6 months prior to the diagnosis. Little things were going on. I'd get up 2-3 times a night to go to the washroom. I was drinking full liters of Kool-Aid in a day on my own. My mom thought I might have had a bladder infection, so we went to the doctor to try and figure that out, and they told us to go to the IWK and get a blood test done. They gave us a call, said, "Pack your bags, you're coming in overnight, you've got type 1 diabetes."
We had no idea what diabetes was. We had no idea what celiac disease was.
And then she explained that this is a disease in your pancreas where your body cannot produce the insulin that you need, and that can cause some serious harm, so you're going to have to take some medication pretty much for the rest of your life through a syringe. I was a little shocked and surprised. I said, "Isn't there a pill? Isn't there something else I can do?" But they said, "No, no, it's going to be a syringe. It's going to be okay. We're just going to teach you how to do it while you're here. Then you'll go home, you'll be fine. Like, everything's going to be all right as long as you take these needles." After that, I learned how to do it and everything was fine. And you cast your fears aside, and you know you can survive. I started out on 2 needles a day, 2 different kind of insulins called Humulin R and Humulin N. And since that, I've progressed to 4 needles a day on Humalog and Humulin. My parents started giving me injections for the first 6 weeks. Then I went to the diabetes camp for 4 years, from when I was 9 to when I was 12. It just made everything so much easier and clearer. I mean, I'd only had diabetes for 6 weeks when I first went. By the end of it, I was confident of what I was doing. I knew more, I understood more. There's staff there, they're helping you the whole way, but you're doing your own needles, you're doing your own blood tests. You get help with your food, but you're doing pretty much your own meal plan.
We ask her now more questions about it, and she educates us. I guess in a way it's her reaction to dealing with things being taken away from her. It's that natural dog with a bone fight in her that says, "I'll take control and I'll do even better."
Celiac disease is in your intestines, where your body will not allow you to digest anything with flour, wheat, oats, or malt in it. So no gluten whatsoever. And if you do, you'll get pretty nasty stomach aches, you'll get sick. I cannot eat any type of bread, crackers, pasta. Most cereals I can't eat. You gotta be really careful when you go out to eat anything. You always have to be reading labels. You always have to be asking everybody, what's in this? How is it made? I'm in the IWK about once every 3 months for my type 1 diabetes. I go in once a year for my celiac checkup. I take 4 injections a day of insulin, a blood test every single time I eat, 5 blood tests, but I'll be going to the IWK where I'm getting my insulin pump all fitted in and put in right, and I figure out how to work it, and that'll limit me to 1 injection pretty much every 3 days. So it's just going to stay in my belly or in my arm or wherever I choose to place it. And it's just going to constantly be pumping insulin into me the way a pancreas does in a body whose pancreas works. This is going to change things dramatically for me because I'm very heavily involved in sports. So if I have a tournament and the game goes over lunchtime, I don't have to be up and eating breakfast at 8:30 and eating my lunch at 10:30. I'll be able to eat like an athlete and not like a diabetic. It's just been really, really crummy, just having it sometimes. And then I turn around and I just like look at my family and I look at my school work and everything I've worked so hard for outside of diabetes and just remind myself that's why I do it. It's just to keep doing what I love to do, like my sports, and continue on with my education. This is is my last year for ringette. It's going to be my last Canadian national championships I attend. It's in Waterloo in April. I'm the goaltender for soccer as well, and on the side I play a bit of hockey when I can. Next year I'm just going to play all hockey. I'd like to play university hockey if I can.
Torn on two sides. One is you wish they never, ever had to go through what they've had to do. Yet on the other side, you're just so proud all the time to see how they've dealt with it and how it's impacted and how she's taken it and run with it. It's just amazing when I sit back and watch all the things that she's done to take control of her life.
The insulin pump, it is going to make a world of difference. The people I've talked to who are on it now say they can't imagine going back to injections.
One of the things that I've commented to many people is, you know, she has all the reasons to have victim thinking and blame reasoning in her life. And she has all these things that happened to her, not because of anything that she did. They just happened. You know, she has all the reasons to think this way, and she doesn't.
This is the C100 FM Radiothon for the IWK Health Center. 100 hours for the kids. The number to call with your gift is 1-800-595-2266.